Hello, fellow graduates. Our school has taught us quite well. We learned that barking on street corners in Times Square is the lowest you can go. We learned that bringer shows are for suckers and people who have friends. We learned that alcohol will never let us down after we've performed comedic seppuku on stage and feel emotionally raped by an audience's lack of positive reaction. A few points to remember before you start your journey leaving tonight. Louis C.K. ruined baby dick jokes for everyone. If you do a baby dick joke, it's over, man. Everybody knows my arm is, like, awkward. It's over, man. Everyone knows better, and they'll just come off as a creepy creep, which you probably are, but that's okay. Things that always do work. Catchy songs. Impressions where you put together items that don't fit, like a gay cat as Elvis Presley with Christopher Walken's voice. You have had and will have many drops. It will be near impossible to be famous someday. It takes a great amount of dedication and narcissism to succeed. So stay positive. Lean delusional, because it's the only way. Don't be discouraged by the jobs you never want but have to have in order to get by. When you're stuck in a mundane job, the kind where you have to ask permission to use the bathroom so someone can take over your desk because you're the first face of the office, but they wait an hour to show up despite your pleas, and then you end up with a urinary tract infection, but they won't let you take time off of work to see a doctor so you can get some Cipro to fix it, so you go a whole week with bloody urine, and it feels like someone is knifing your urethra over and over again when you pee, but then you finally get to go to the doctor and you get the antibiotic. But by then, you can't even stand up straight because the infection has spread to your kidneys and the antibiotic offers relief quickly, but it's so strong you end up with a yeast infection. So the next week you're all uncomfortable and self-conscious in your job with a terrible itch and forget about intimacy for the next week. Don't be discouraged by that. You won't have that job forever. So remember, it's really hard out there, but only you can find your voice. Create those moments nobody else can. Even if you're up here talking about what kind of porn addiction Gotti might have, or you're doing an impression of an autistic parrot with a cleft palate, or you're just being female. For better or worse, that moment is yours, so take it. So what if you're not curing cancer? We're not meant to live forever anyway.
People are so rude, I'm telling you. You know, they're always asking me these really embarrassing questions like, what do I eat, how much I eat, putting food in my face, telling me to eat it? You know what? Look, I'm not an idiot, okay? I get it. I have an eating disorder. It's very obvious, okay? But really, people, how much humiliation do us overweight people have to go through?